Hey everyone, Forrest here with Rocky Mountain School of Photography, and today we're gonna take a look at what's new in version 13.3 of Adobe Lightroom Classic. I do wanna say, if you are an Adobe Lightroom user, I have made a special video for you. You can find it linked in the description. Let's dive in. So the first thing, probably the least exciting for a lot of you, but most exciting for some of you, is that we now have tethering support for Sony cameras. This is super exciting if you're a Sony shooter. There's a whole suite of Sony cameras that are now supported through Lightroom's tethering tool. So that's the first thing. I'm not gonna demo that. I'm not a Sony shooter, but that is out there for those of you who shoot Sony. The next new thing has to do with organization. It's a pretty small tweak here, but if you go into your attribute filter, there is a new option to filter either exported images or never exported images. So again, new little option. I think this is pretty cool, actually. Sometimes I'll be looking through my photos and I'll think, man, which ones have I already sent out there? Have I already exported to my desktop for, say, Instagram or something like that? Now, very easily, we can just tell it to show us only our not exported files. It'll hide the ones that have already been exported. So you can kind of see what's going on as far as what you still need to export, what you still need to work through. Nice little tool there to have. The big changes though happen in editing. Namely, there's two new changes in the editing world. The first one is the new generative AI removal, which is amazing. So I'm gonna start off with actually an impressive shot, an impressive example of this. I don't know that the shot's impressive, but the example is, we're gonna take this photo, I'm gonna go to the develop module, and immediately I'm gonna go to the new remove tool. You'll notice the little icon has changed. It's no longer a band-aid, it's now the remove. And I'm gonna make sure that it's on the little eraser mode here. I'm gonna turn on generative AI. You'll have to agree here. This does use Adobe's Firefly AI generation technology. You'll also note it is in early access. But then all I'm gonna do, I wanna remove this tree here out of the photo. So, this is a very challenging removal. If you've ever used, you know, Lightroom before, you'll know that this is probably one of those things that I would send into Photoshop. And 5 years ago, this would be probably a 2-hour job. But I'm gonna go ahead and paint over this tree here. And you'll notice it automatically takes you into mask refinement to ask if you wanna do any refinements to the mask. I'm happy here. I'm gonna go ahead and click apply. And it's going to use generative remove. Now, this is really powerful, and having this in Lightroom is pretty amazing. We'll see what it comes up with here. I've run it a couple times ahead of time, and you guys can see it didn't disappoint. It did an amazing job rebuilding this. So what this tool does is it uses AI to figure out what should be there in place of what you're trying to remove. So if I wanna show you guys a before after, I can click this little eyeball down here, and you guys can see here's the piece of wood, and now it's gone. And the AI has rebuilt the reflection. Also, I will show you, if you click on the point that you just removed to select it, you also have some variations you can click through. So here's the first variation, here's the second one, and here's the third one. So you can kind of see which one looks the best. In my mind, I think that one looks the most accurate. And then additionally, you can refresh, which will get you 3 new variations if it didn't do a very good job. One other thing is the generative AI can be used in conjunction with object aware. So if you're trying to remove something and you want the computer to detect what you're trying to remove and then also try to remove it using AI, we can use those in conjunction. So as an example, if I was trying to say get rid of this window back here, I could turn on object aware and then paint over this window, and object aware is gonna try to identify the window itself. You can see it drew a nice little box around it, and then when I click apply, generative AI is gonna do its best to remove that section. Now, this obviously depends on the performance of your computer and a lot of factors how quickly this can run, but you can see it did a pretty amazing job. It rebuilt the kind of converging vanishing point lines here that we have on this image. And if I go ahead and close this, we can see if you didn't know I did something there, you'd be really hard pressed to find that as an adjustment. And that's just amazing. I also had quite a bit of fun kind of turning off generative AI and seeing what the non-generative AI would do. So you can click a point, you can turn off generative and see what it would do. And you can see it's like total chaos. It doesn't look good at all. If we go to the log example, we click on that point that we made, and we turn off generative, here's what the non-generative AI removal would do, and we can see it's a, you know, it looks like what we've experienced with Lightroom retouching up until this point. So I am blown away by this. It's not perfect. I have run it on some star photos trying to like remove, you guys can see I've already run it here on this image, but I've run it on some star trail images and you can see it does a fine job, but there was a satellite trail there. It's not perfect though. There are definitely some areas where you can see the stars getting kind of gross and wavy. It's not quite perfect, but it's amazing. And honestly, if I can say so, like less stuff to have to go to Photoshop for, that's amazing. That's what I'm after. So that's our first new tool. The second new thing is just really some changes to the lens blur feature. They updated the model, they made it a little bit better. So now when you're in lens blur, when you wanna take a background and knock it out, you turn on apply, you're gonna get better results with the tool. I think they also removed the early access badging. This is now an official tool. I believe that was with this update that was removed. Is it perfect yet? No, it's not perfect. Like you'll still get little weird halos around things like, oh look, a thumb halo. You know, strange bits that will happen, but it's pretty darn good. And what they've also added, if I reset this, is some presets. Let me go to this photo here of Sarah that we worked on a minute ago. In the preset section, there are new adaptive blur background presets where you can be like, oh, let's get a strong blur background. And it will analyze the photo and apply the correct amount of blur for what you're looking for. Let's see what Swirl does. So this is controlling what the bokeh in the background looks like. Things like that. So pretty cool that we have adaptive presets now as well for the background lens blur. So pretty cool there, model's been updated. It works a little bit better. I find it looks a little bit more convincing. But you all, like if we compare what we were at before, right, here's the unblurred photo. We also used the removal for the window. Let me actually use the generative AI removal so we can kind of see a full effect of these new tools. And there it is, right? We've got our background removal. We've got our blur. Pretty amazing stuff. So everybody, that's what's new in Adobe Lightroom Classic. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, drop a like down below. I would really appreciate it. If you want to learn about Lightroom Classic masking and all of the local tools and advanced masking tools there are, we actually built a really comprehensive online class for that. You can learn more down in the description. Finally, hit subscribe to stay up to date with future videos. I would love you to follow along. We make videos every week on photography, editing, all kinds of photo-related things. Hope to catch you in a future video. Thanks, everybody, and I'll see you later.